Hello class 11th, this video is for you. Yesterday I gave you one video related to the lesson A Portrait of a Lady. Now this is part 2, and I've told you already that in the beginning the narrator used to live with his grandmother in the village, and they were very good friends. They were all the time 24 hours they supposed to be together. But when his parents settled down in the city, then they called them up, and at that time they were given the same room. It means grandmother and he were given the same room, but he started going to the English school by bus, and grandmother was not able to go along with him. And besides this one, there was no feeding to dogs, so she took to the birds. It means she started feeding sparrows over there, and this was a turning point in their friendship. Now children, after this one, the next over there, when at that time when he would go to school and would be back, at that time the grandmother would ask that what did he learn or what was he taught. Like here, I'm next to that one, I'm reading it out. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning, the law of gravity, Archimedes principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. Actually, she would ask that what did he learn in the school, then he would tell that he learned science, that is law of gravity, Archimedes principle, about the geography, that is the world being round, and of course the English words and the Western science, and these all things would make her unhappy. Why? Because she was a very simple lady. According to her, children should be taught in the school about God and the scriptures, means religious books, and those were not taught there. One day I announced that we were being given music lessons. She was very disturbed. To her, music had lewd associations. It was the monopoly of the harlots and the beggars, and not meant for gentlefolk. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. Like here, one day he told that music as a subject would be taught to him. She got disturbed. She didn't like it, because according to her, that singing was associated with the low category people. It means that is beggars, like who do begging by singing. And the harlots means the women, those who do singing and earn the money for their livelihood. And according to her, not the gentle people used to do that. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She did not say anything, but she kept quiet. And this means that she disapproved that one. She didn't like it. She rarely talked to me after that. And after that one, she stopped talking to him. When I went to university, next paragraph, I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. It means, firstly, he was schooling, then he went to college. When he went to college, then for higher studies, he needed a separate room, and it was given to him. So the common link, what was a common link? The room was a common link between their friendship. So it was cut off. Now, hardly they used to meet there. So the grandmother accepted her seclusion, means loneliness. With resignation means she stopped taking interest in household matters. That is, she rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. While she sat in the veranda, breaking the bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirpings. Some came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulders, some even sat on her head. She smiled but never shooed them away. It used to be a happiest half an hour of the day for her. Now children, what happened after that one? That most of the time she started spending on the spinning wheel. She would keep on spinning the cotton, and she would keep on reciting the prayers. Besides that one, in the afternoon, she would relax for half an hour. She would sit in the veranda and she would break the bread into small, small bits and she would throw them to the sparrows. These sparrows, they would sit on her head, on her legs, and like Parsmin sat on her legs, shoulders, and she used to be very happy. And when they would sit on her head, she would smile and would never make them fly away. Shoot means made them fly away. She would never make them fly away. And then she used to be, that was the happiest time for her. Happiest hour of the day, it means it was the best time for her when she used to be very much happy. Here, children, when I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years, and at her age, no one could tell her. But my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. Like here, decided to go abroad. He completed his schooling, then college, and for the higher studies, his parents thought to send him to abroad. Actually, he went to England for the higher studies. And then he did his post-graduation from there only. But he was worried that his grandmother, who was very old then, and he was going for 5 years, that he did not know whether he would be able to see her back. So he was becoming emotional. Now, she was not even sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of a rosary. Silently, she kissed my forehead, and when I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. Like here, when I decide, like here, she came to leave me. It means she was a practical lady. She knew that for a good education, her grandson was going abroad. So she controlled on herself. She did not show her emotions. She kept on praying, and she was counting the beads of a rosary, and then she kissed his forehead and blessed him. And when I left, I cherished the moist imprint. It means the sign of the kiss on his forehead he took along with him as her blessings, and he thought that might be the last sign of physical contact between them when she touched him, and maybe after 5 years he won't be able to see her. He thought like that. Next paragraph. But that was not so. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. She did not look a day older. She still had no time for words. And while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear her reciting her prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows, whom she fed longer and with frivolous rebukes. It means when he was back after completing his PG, means post-graduation, then what did he find that one? That his grandmother was there on the station to welcome him also. Then, that is, she held him very tightly, and at that time he noticed that she was still praying and she was not looking even a day older. It means how he left her, she was the same physically. The first day also he noticed that she was very happy, and she fed the sparrows. Like generally she used to feed for half an hour, but that day she fed them for longer period and with frivolous rebukes, means with light abuses. That is generally in daily language, daily language, some people speak out of love even also. In that way she did. In the evening, a change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the women of the neighborhood, got an old drum and started to sing. For several hours she thumbed the sagging. In the evening, a change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the women of the neighborhood and she got an old drum and she started thumping and singing. That is the homecoming of warriors. Now here, sagging. Sagging means children lose. That is there. Now this is the next page. Sagging skins of the dilapidated drum and sang the homecoming of the warriors. Because according to her, she was very happy and her grandson was back and he was no less than a warrior. Okay, so she just here, she took him as a warrior only. After completing his education, was back and he was hale and hearty, so she was very happy. We had to persuade her to stop to avoid overstraining. It means family members asked her not to take that much, not to get excited that much, so that let her not be sick. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. And the writer is telling this was the first time that he noticed that she did not pray. It means he was surprised also that out of happiness, out of excitement, she did that. The next morning she was taken ill. It was a mild fever and the doctor told us that it would go. But my grandmother thought differently. She told us that her end was near. She said that since only a few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray. She was not going to waste any more time talking to us. The next morning she was taken ill, and the next morning due to overstraining, that is, she became ill. A mild fever was there, and the family thought that because she got exhausted, that's why that fever was there. Even the doctor told the same. But grandmother, she thought differently because she knew that her end was there. It means her death was near. What is that one? She was feeling sorry that day before her death, she stopped praying. So now she didn't want to waste any time by talking to the family members. So she kept on praying, lying in her bed. We protested, but she ignored our protest. She lay peacefully in bed, praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. A peaceful pallor spread over her face and we knew that she was dead. We protested. It means nothing would happen, she would be all right. But she did not, she ignored their protests. She did not listen to them. She was lying peacefully in her bed and she was praying and counting her beads of rosary. But what happened? All of a sudden her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her fingers, and in that way they came to know that she was no more. A peaceful paleness was spreading over her face and we knew that she was dead. And it means we knew that she was no more, and it means she had died. Now children, last paragraph. We lifted her. Now pallor, in the previous paragraph, pallor means paleness. There was pale spreading over her face. We lifted her off the bed and, as is customary, laid on the ground and covered her with the red shroud. Customary. Generally, the dead bodies are not left on the bed. So she was also taken to the ground and then she was covered with red shroud. Shroud means cover. Children, here is a very nice question, why the red was covered though she was a widow. Let me just tell you, because she died completing her life, a good life. And besides that one, leaving a happy family behind. So that she completed the life gracefully. And that's why the family used to do like this. That is, it is not taken as like that. It means like a widow, though she was. But that is, they were happy out of that one, that it was the last rite of her life and that it should be go on nicely. That's why she was covered with red cover. After a few hours of mourning means they were weeping, we left her alone to make arrangements for her funeral. It means the family became busy in doing the other arrangements. In the evening, we went to her room with a crude stretcher to take her to be cremated. In the evening, we went to her room with a crude stretcher to take her to be cremated. It means that stretcher was prepared. So that is, the sun was setting and had lit her room and veranda with the blaze of golden light. It means the evening sun was there and the golden light was coming to her room. We stopped halfway in the courtyard, all over the veranda and in her room, right up where she lay dead, stiff wrapped in the red shroud. Thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. There was no chirpings. It means when they were back there, that is, what did they see? That there were thousands of sparrows were there and they were in the whole veranda and they were also up to the dead body of the grandmother that is there, and there was no sound at all, as if these birds, these poor birds also had come to know about their death. We felt sorry for the birds and my mother fetched some breads for them. It means they felt very bad. Then mother thought they must be hungry, they must be Missing that, so she went inside and she brought the bread and she broke them into the crumbs. She broke it into little crumbs. Little crumbs means small, small pieces, the way my grandmother used to do, and threw it to them. The sparrows took no notice of the bread. When she carried my grandmother's corpse off, they flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs into the dustbin. Like here, children, the way my grandmother used to, they threw. It means that she made small, small pieces. She gave to the birds. And then when they carried, that is the dead body, corpse means dead body, to the cremation ground, at that time, the birds also flew quietly. And to the surprise of everyone, the next morning, the sweeper had to sweep the breadcrumbs into the dustbin because the birds did not pick up any. It means, children, the birds were also the part of the morning. They did not take even a single breadcrumb over there. Now you can notice that even the birds and the animals, they also notice if there is any such happening occurs in the family. Children, you must have understood this chapter very nicely. That is, explanation part is over. And in the next class, I will be giving to you its summary along with its notes. It means the question answers, that one. Okay, children, take care and work hard. And bye now, that is 11th class. Okay.